Here I'm at Michael's, just getting some last minute supplies and re-upping on some colors that I need for a paint party that I'm having for some staff appreciation. I only needed like 3 or 4 colors, but something about being in the arts and crafts store where I just want to see if there's anything else I want because I really don't need it. So of course, I went to the aisle I needed to be in, and I got some colors, and I'm just getting some heavy body colors because when I do my paint and sips, I really like to have quality paint, especially if we're doing a piece where they need to get the background done first because I want it to be very opaque, very thick. So I'm just getting those colors and a few other things. So these are the paints that I typically use for my paint parties, and most of them have like the half mark, meaning that it's half transparent, half opaque. But recently using these, like the fluid one, I don't know what it is. I actually started using it by accident because I was working with the school and they got this brand instead of this one. Well, it's the same brand, but this product instead of this one. And I actually like using this one. Obviously, I guess it's because it's more fluid, but it shows up really cute on the canvas. So today, I think I'm actually gonna get another one of these too. I'm running low on a few colors. It's amazing. Y'all, I'm literally having to like get over, like I'm literally doing a social experiment on myself doing this because I've never like fully had the tripod out in public where I'm shopping. So I hope y'all appreciate it because I know people are looking at me like I'm crazy, but I'm in this new era where I'm just like, I don't care. They're never gonna see me again. Well, the people, the employees will, because I'm in here 24/7. I know they hate to see me coming, but the other people, so yeah.
Side of it, we are still alive, people. We are still alive. Onitsuka, of course, sues them for everything they're worth. Nike countersues. It's a long and dramatic lawsuit, but in the end, Nike wins and stays alive. They even get some damages awarded to them from Onitsuka. They signed the fleets more, an entire look, tracksuits, shoes, shirts, shorts, everything. And so Nike felt they needed to compete. And this, of course, increases revenue even further, just more revenue streams. One quick break to tell you that this episode is brought to you by All the Hacks. All the Hacks is a great podcast all about upgrading your life, money, and travel. It's hosted by my friend Chris Hutchinson.
Why would you say that in traffic, sir?
So relax. If you want to learn about optimizing your credit card points, he's got an episode on that, maybe $20 at the time. So the competitors do this just to benchmark and say, look, here's a competitive shoe for $250. So you have to,
y'all,
as if they're
the way
$250.
This man is following me. Oh,
so it racks
my gosh,
up this
I'm
huge
scared.
Tax bill. It's totally illegitimate. It's a dirty trick. We're going to
I don't even know
but
which
works.
Way I
and,
can
and
go
so
to get away
telling
from
him
you
owe $25 million.
Yo, this man is following me! And I try to smile and say no, because knowing men, he might just knock himself into my freaking car. Like, ugh.
Oh my gosh. Today was going to be my errands day. I was going to get everything in one shot, but it's something about being outside more than 2 hours. I can't take it. And I'm glad I realized that about myself, because before I just used to get mad, but now I realize. And it's the summer, so it was never going to happen. I was never going to be out more than 2 hours. And I'm just like, because I've been putting it off for so long, and I'm just like, I'm not going out tomorrow. Other than my paper, I'm not going out tomorrow. And I don't want to go out on Sunday. And then, like, it's just a lot, because the way I create my schedule and the way I prioritize my time, I'm just like, I'm not going over there to play these games. Y'all close there or not, I don't have time for it. I just don't. It's different this time because usually I have my team help me with the canvases and stuff. But because they're part-time, and this is around the time where everybody's getting back to the office or going back to school, it's just like...
Alpha! It's Alpha!
I gotta do
to most of this by myself. Like, they were able to help some. Like, Kayla's helping me tomorrow. My sister was able to help me some. But I'm just so used to everybody being hands on deck. Like, when I tell y'all, I was actually just listening to a podcast, and the woman was saying, it was called The Journey with Morgan DeBron. I love her. Actually, one day, I'm getting off text, but one day, or probably in this video, I'm going to list like all my favorite podcasts. Like, I have been a podcast girly since last year, but this year, I just been finding all the good people. Or really, I feel like I'm in an era where they are coming to me, all the information and their personalities and these creators are like making themselves accessible to me. Like, I was supposed to find them right now. But anyway, where was I at? Yeah, but anyway, she was talking about in the podcast, Morgan was interviewing someone, I think she was a writer, and she was saying how when people like say, like proudly say that they're solopreneurs, she runs. She runs because, oh, if you're sick or you're on vacation or something happens, then everything is shut down. And I was just like, that's so true. And not even just like, oh, you're shut down once something becomes unavailable because only you. I'm thinking, who wants to tackle all this by themselves? Like, at a certain point, you have to, because you don't have the resources or money to hire people. But who willingly wants to do this all by themselves? I don't. And it's just like, you might be doing it well, but are you doing it the best? No, ma'am, probably not. And I don't want that. I don't want that for anybody. I don't want that for myself. I don't want that for my business, because if it's just one person running the show with all these different heads on, it's just like, what is the actual quality of the work? And that's no shade to anybody. Like, even me, like when I was first starting out, me doing all this stuff, I might have been great in this one area, but because it's just me, in the other areas, I might be given 50%, 30% because my 90 is here. I don't know. Don't ask me about math, because no.
Complicate. There's no need for you to hesitate. probably buy one of those little sheds from Home Depot.
Oh, storage, yeah.
That way is my little studio.
Yeah.
And you know, Tate can do that too.
Corners and drag in. Once it dries out, just dip your brush in a little bit of water and get some more paint.